guys, welcome back to my channel, Life with Patty. And so you know what, I'm getting a little tired of doing some paper crafting, so I got this pumpkin super thin cutout, wooden cutout at the Dollar Tree, and I think I'm gonna do it in button art. But I want to first do a base coating of orange just in case the buttons don't cover everything. Back to yucky nails again. Sorry guys, that's real life. That's the way it is. So anyways, I've got a Dixie paper plate here. I put some paint on there. I'm even gonna paint the stem orange, it's okay. And it's not gonna be like super, if it's not completely covered perfect, it's okay, because I'm just gonna cover the whole thing with buttons. But just in case there's little pieces of space between the buttons, I want it to not have the wooden background. Sides just to make sure, so when you hang it on the wall, it looks nice with the back. That dry and we'll be back. Okay, it dries super quick, especially when your house is warm because it's 111 outside. Took the dog out just to go to the bathroom, and poor little guy, he was all when we got ready to come back in. So yeah, my craft room is warm, but perfect time to paint, right? So here we go. Thank you. some browns. That's what I want to use on my pumpkin. And so if you buy buttons that are all just one color category, it's super, super expensive, because believe me, I've done it. And it's way cheaper to do it this way. I do have a lot of brown buttons in here because I was doing a project where I was separating them. So I've got quite a few brown buttons, but I do need to get some orange and some green. The really big buttons aren't the most ideal. The smaller buttons, like this size, are perfect, but it's kind of hard to, you know, find just those. Like these, they're really not that great for what we're doing. That's not for, those are more for if you do like a flower and you use the whole piece as the centerpiece. I'll show you that sometime. Like this is a good size. So this is what I have to do. I just have to go through all these buttons and find some orange, and I don't want the big huge ones, but the orange and the green and brown, and I might even find, I don't know if we'll do a few yellows or not. I don't think, see these big ones, not good. Anyways, all right, you guys, I am going to just turn off the camera and continue my hunt for buttons. This is like a perfect button. All right, you guys, so I separated out some buttons, and I've got, you know, pumpkins aren't always completely orange, so we'll see how we do here. I've got different colors here and shapes, and then I also have these little tiny buttons like this that I got, which are great, but boy, these get used up fast. And this was not cheap. I can't remember. I think it was like $10. So I've got some tweezers here that I use sometimes. I'm going to try to use this Fabric Fix glue and see how it works. It'll be the first time. And what I do is I just squirt a little bit on here and rub it around real good. The reason why I use the fabric glue is because it's not water-based, and so it ends up, your stuff sticks to it better. And I did not know that until my dear friend Karen Luke told me that. And, you know, those little, those little tricks that you learn from different people. So I was like so happy when Karen told me that. And she's like, because it's not water-based, sometimes it works better. And it works perfect for my button art. So it looks like it's sticking on there just fine. So I'm just gonna, and I just put a little bit on at a time. Don't do a big area because it dries quite fast. And then you've just wasted all your glue.
All right, you guys, so I just wanted to give you an update. I finished the pumpkin, and so I used all kinds of sizes, and I used yellow, orange, green, and browns, and I accidentally cut off the little, they had a little piece of string here, and when I was taking everything, the tags off, I accidentally cut it off. So I put this on for now because I didn't want, when I started painting it, for that hole to close up. So I will buy some twine tomorrow at work and I will put it through there. But I thought it turned out really cute. I'm going to gift it away. I also am in a fall and Halloween collab, so I might use it for that first and then I'll send it off in friend mail. But anyways, I thought that one turned out really cute. I like it. And now on to another project. Have a great day, everybody.